is out there. It is Andre Ullefuhr that's riding with the Juno Promotions 3 car that belongs to Clint Renard, a front runner in the Clubman's Racing at Killarney, and a man that's very knowledgeable on the technical side and has done a lot on the management side of that style of motorsport at the Wisconsin Motor Club Killarney International Raceway. So this is a first for the E36 guys, an initiative which is pretty much initiated and run by Zach Hunewald. And they're going to come around. They will take the MSA start flag. They will do one lap, and then they will go into the figure of eight scenario. This is a test round, and Tygerberg is looking at this as a possible additional class for the 2020 season to see if this is an option entertainment-wise for us here at Tygerberg Raceway.
Right up front, it's Zach behind me.
In the 24 years of the running of Tygerberg Raceway, never ever had an initiative like this, and this could be something that becomes pretty popular, and with something involved with a 328 he's lots of power. He's an accomplished drifter, overtrack racer, main circuit racer, you name it. Zach Hunewald has done it, raced it, built it, designed it, sprayed it, stickered it, and set it up and driven it to perfection. And there's not a lot that he hasn't done, and he is pretty much the quickest man out there with the E36 car.
Been hassled there by Ryan Cato. Ryan sits out there in that second place. There's Tuscarora now, followed there by Leon Smith and Sean Mayer, and getting it all slightly wrong there. Behind Sean Mayer, it's Dylan L. Behind Dylan L, it is Grant Webster, followed there by Tristan L, Sean Van Vijk, and Andre Ullefuhr.
Something different, something nice, something great. And you're going to get that the guys are going to start learning how to cut the lines as they go into the infield.
Yeah.
Webster overshoots it with a 78 car. That brings the 73 in a whole heap closer in there behind him. And Sean Van Vijk also closes up as well.
Flag as well, and around the circuit. slowing down, and I'm trying to see what has caused the red flag.
Well, I take it that maybe they thought that there was less laps than what the lap counter shows. The guys in the middle, I don't think, can't see the lap counter. So maybe it was supposed to be only 5 laps and not 8 laps.
I was supposed to do a 10-lap race. I'm not sure exactly what happened now. There was no checkered flag. You see the thingies?
There's bits and pieces of something there.
That could be a lot of debris out there. So they just brought this out. The problem is...